Having a great idea is not enough. You can have a best idea about the best project in the world. If nobody understands what you want to make, you will never get it built in the first place. And we already talked about that a couple of times, and we already talked about why communication is important and why it's important to explain yourself to your team, to your clients, to the people who will use the building. But there's another element to the communication that we didn't talk about so much, and this is that you not only need to explain yourself, you also need to excite. You need to get people excited about your idea. You need your team to get excited about your idea, because then they will work better. Remember, the best work and the most creative work comes from the things that we want to do, not the things that we have to do. And on the other hand, it's very important also that you get your future users and general public excited about your project, because it is them that will give life to your building. Otherwise, your building will be left empty, half-used, and the people will just not feel motivated to give it life and to continue living through time. Now, obviously, the best way to excite people about your building is by making a great design, right? But very often, you need to explain and excite people about your project before you have the actual design, the building finished. And that's why architects employ various media to explain and excite people about their projects. So let's just see what are those media that architects used. Obviously, first thing is drawings. Architects use drawings a lot, and most obviously because these drawings are fairly very technical, these are used to, let's say, explain the project. Also, you can put a little excitement into it by making the drawing themselves beautiful, like a piece of beautiful graphic design that will inspire people to maybe give their best, more or less inspire collaborators first to give their best while they work in the project. So we have drawings, then we have a physical model, which is the thing that you're making in this course. Physical models are also mostly used to explain the space. These are really perfect medium to explain the space, because we get to move around, we can see the space and the project from this different perspectives. And also, if we go one step further to make these models beautiful and engaging in themselves, then we can also get people excited. But also, models are very often a means to communicate the space. So mostly the method to explain things. Third media that architects use are visual media such as images and video, and especially images is something that's most often used, a way that architects communicate their idea to each other and to general public. And we're going to talk about images later, as we're going to ask you to do some of images of your project as a final presentation of your project. And then there's a fourth medium that is getting more employed lately, which is interactive media such as VR, that lets us get into the project and experience, really immerse ourselves in the project. And obviously, out of all these four medias, this one is most engaging and most, let's say, most exciting. So there we have drawings, we have models, we have images and video, and we have interactive media. And we use all those to explain and excite. Now, in the next video, we're going to talk about images, what makes a good image, and how to go about making it.